Hey there, I'm James, you're watching Accounting Stuff, and today I'll show you how to use Xero. This isn't a sponsored video, there are no affiliate links, so let's jump right in. What is Xero? Xero is a cloud-based accounting software package. It's very similar to QuickBooks Online, which we covered already on this channel. But while QuickBooks Online was introduced in the United States of America in 2001, Xero was founded in New Zealand. It was born in 2006, so it's a bit younger. However, nowadays Xero is a global company and it's extremely popular amongst small to medium-sized businesses. So let's see what all the fuss is about. What does Xero do? Like I mentioned, it's an accounting software package, so it helps you do your bookkeeping. It lives in the cloud, so you can access it from anywhere, and it automates a lot of boring tasks for you, which should save you a lot of time. I'll show you what I mean by that in a moment, but first, which version of Xero is right for you? In the USA, you've got three plans to choose from: early, growing, and established. Early is the cheapest plan at $12 per month, and it's aimed at new businesses, sole traders, and the self-employed. The growing plan costs a bit more. It's $34 per month. It removes the caps on invoices, quotes, and bills, and it lets you reconcile your transactions in bulk. Established is the most expensive plan at $65 per month. With Established, you can track projects, claim expenses, and you can get some in-depth analytics. Now listen up. If you need multiple currencies, then this is the plan for you. Sadly, the other two don't offer that. And keep in mind that payroll costs another $39 per month. What does Xero look like? Welcome to the Xero dashboard. You can find your company name in the top left corner. As you can see, we're working with the US version of the demo company. That sky blue bar above me is called the navigation bar. It comes with links to the organization menu, the dashboard, which is where we are now, the business button, the accounting menu, payroll, projects, and contacts. To the right-hand side of me, we've got the create button, the search function, and the notification bell. It looks just like that one that you'll see on this channel when you hit the subscribe button. We've also got the help button, connected apps, and finally, your user profile. Below that, there's also a link to your login history. On the dashboard, you get a snapshot of your business's financials. You can see the balances of your bank accounts over time, your cash in and out by month, your account watch list, the invoices owed to you, a summary of all your expense claims, and the bills that you need to pay. If you click the Edit Dashboard button, then you can shuffle things around and hide the widgets that you aren't interested in. How does Xero work? Let's head up to the navigation bar and this dark blue button with your company's name. This is the organization menu. If we click on it, you can upload and access important files. And below that, there's your organization settings. These are split into two columns: general and features. Under the general column, you can access your organization details. It's here that you can change your basic information, update your display name, your legal trading name, and add a logo. You can also enter your line of business, pick an organization type, add a business registration number, an employer identification number, and an organization description. Below that, you can fill in your contact details: your postal address, physical address, telephone, email, and website. When you're done making changes, click Save and we'll head back to organization settings. Next up, we have users. If you go in there, then you'll get a breakdown of everyone with access to your Xero file. You can also add more users, including Xero support, modify permissions, and remove them if necessary. If you signed up to the established plan, then you can head into currencies to add more if you need to. Click Add Currency, pick the one you're after, and hit the green button. Easy squeezy. Connected apps is where you manage your third-party connections to Xero. We don't have any right now because we're in the demo company, So we'll move on over to the features column. In invoice settings, you can customize and preview your invoices. There's that logo we added earlier. You can also see what they look like on a phone versus a computer screen. Payment services is where you manage the payment options available to your customers on your sales invoices. You can see what's connected at the moment. You can also add credit and debit cards via Stripe or direct debits. Within email settings, you can make templates to tailor the emails that you send out of Xero. And in check styles, you can change how your checks look like. If your customers or suppliers use Xero, you can connect with them directly from Xero to Xero by sending them a Xero network invite. That way you can share invoices directly into each other's sales and purchases ledgers. You can also add custom contact links to build shortcuts to other systems. Let's jump back to the organization menu. Beneath settings, you'd usually see an option for subscription and billing. But we're in the demo company right now, so it's not there. But that's where you'd upgrade, downgrade, or cancel your subscription. If you have multiple Xero organizations, then you can switch between them here or add a new one. And further down, we have a section called Do More with Xero. These are some more add-ons. You can use Gusto to automate your payroll and tax filing. You can capture expense claims, use Analytics Plus for short-term cash flow projections and business snapshots. There's also Workflow Max and HubDoc, which automates the process of entering bills and receipts. There are plenty of plugins to choose from. In the App Store, you can search for whatever you're after or browse the most popular ones below. At the bottom of the organization menu, you can access My Xero. In here, you can switch between your different Xero organizations, manage your subscriptions and billing accounts, and fiddle with your individual profile and account settings. And that's the organization menu. Now, let's head on over to this little plus symbol. Don't worry, we'll come back for these. This is called the Create button, and we use it to create new transactions. For example, if you sell a product or a service to a customer, then you might need to produce an invoice. Filling this out is simple. Under Who is it for, we'll enter the customer name, add an item, a quantity, and a price. You can then choose the account that you want the invoice coded to. In this case, that's sales. You can also add a tax rate and a region if you need to. And that's it. You can preview the invoice to see what it looks like and approve and email once it's ready to send. You can also create new bills. You might want to use this if a supplier has sent you an invoice with a due date. Like this one. If we fill out all the details in here, then we can record it as an expense in our income statement. When it's ready, click Approve. With the Create button, you can also add new contacts, create quotes and purchase orders. There's even an option to post a manual journal. But I wouldn't recommend doing this unless you're a qualified accountant or bookkeeper. Bills are one way to record expenses, but you can also enter them on a cash basis when the money leaves your bank account. You can do this by creating a spend money transaction here, or you can wait and do this during the bank rec, which we'll get into in a moment on the accounting tab. Similarly, you can record bank receipts and transfers by creating receive money and transfer money transactions. But we can do these during the bank rec as well. Let's move on from the Create button. If you're looking for a specific transaction or contact, then you can use the search function to find it. The notification bell is fairly self-explanatory. You'll get notified on product updates and things like that. If you find these annoying, like I do, then you can go into notification settings to turn them off. In the Help menu, you can search for support articles on whatever you're stuck on. The recommendations will pop up below. You can also contact Xero support if you can't find the answer here. It's online support only. Sadly, there's no phone number for you to ring. But if you raise a case and they can't resolve it online, then they'll give you a call. It's also free, which is nice. We've also got a link to the advisor directory, which you can use to find an accountant or bookkeeper near you. Connected Apps gives you a list of the integrations that you've signed up for, along with another link to the App Store. Your user profile gives you another way to update your individual profile and account settings. Right, let's get down to business. The business menu helps you do your day-to-day tasks. If you're signed up to Analytics Plus, then you'll find a link to your short-term cash flow projection. As they say, cash is king, so it's useful to keep on top of any invoices owed to you and the bills that you've got to pay. The business snapshot gives you some nice charts covering your profitability, efficiency, and financial position. It's set to year to date at the moment, but you can change the period if that's your jam. These next three options are all geared towards sales. First up is invoices, which gives you a breakdown of all your sales invoices. You can check when they're due, how much they're for. There's also a status column which shows you if they've been paid or if you are awaiting payment. We don't want any doubtful debts now, do we? You can also turn on invoice reminders if you want Xero to follow up on overdue invoices for you. Reminders can be sent automatically on the dates of your choosing. Below invoices, we have quotes. Here you can send professional looking estimates to your customers for potential work. Then we have the sales overview. It's got a summary of all your invoices and quotes. You can see the payments that you're waiting on, what's overdue, and who owes you the most money. Don't like to see this red. Ridgeway University? No bueno. The next three options in the business menu are devoted to your outgoings. Bills to pay gives us a breakdown of all your purchase invoices, where we can see what we've paid and what's awaiting payment. In purchase orders, you can get a breakdown of the orders that we've requested from various suppliers. Once raised, these can go through your approval process. Just like the sales overview, we have a purchases overview. This time it summarizes your bills and purchase orders. There's a chart showing your upcoming bills, which you can expand, and we can see what's overdue. At the bottom of the business menu, you can capture your employee expense claims, monitor checks, and manage your products and services. Items that you add to this list can be quickly added to invoices and bills to save you time. Over to my favorite menu, accounting. This is where you manage your bank accounts, run reports, and access advanced settings. If we click on bank accounts, then you can see the ones that are already active. In this case, that's a checking account with a graph of its balance over time and a savings account with nothing in it. We can add new bank accounts by clicking this button right here. You can connect your bank accounts to Xero to import your transactions through automatically via the live bank feed. I recommend doing this. It'll save you a lot of time. Trust me. The bank reconciliation is a key part of accounting. As you can see, this checking account has 29 items to reconcile. So let's explore these, see what they are. On the left, we have all the statement lines from your bank, and on the right, we need to make sure that these are recorded or matched to existing transactions in Xero. This is very important. If we don't do this, our accounts aren't accurate. Xero will attempt to match as many of these for us as possible. If you're happy with them, click OK. But inevitably, some bank statement lines won't be matched. If necessary, we can create the transactions ourselves. That's the customer or supplier that they relate to, the account that we want to code them to, and a brief description. Once you're happy, click OK. You might keep getting similar transactions that take place over and over again. For these ones, you can create a bank rule to allocate them automatically. But what about reports? Xero includes a whole heap of reporting templates. You can find your tax reports near the bottom, and your income statement, balance sheet, and cash flow statement in the financial statements section. Click on the little star to add a report to your favorites. Your income statement or statement of profit and loss is where you measure your financial performance. It summarizes your revenues and expenses over a period of time. You can find your business's net profit on the bottom line. Favorited reports also appear in the accounting menu. See, there's the cash flow statement we added a moment ago. It reveals your cash inflows and outflows over a period of time. And there's the balance sheet. It tells us your financial position, giving us a snapshot of all assets, liabilities, and equity at a point in time. The advanced menu brings up some of the more complex features and settings. Here you can find and recode transactions, work directly with manual journals, manage the fixed assets register, and your chart of accounts. Again, you can access all your favorites via the accounting menu, but I'd recommend getting an accountant or bookkeeper to help you out with these ones. If you signed up to payroll, then you'd have a tab for that up here as well. That's where you can manage all your employees and contractors. And Xero projects allows you to quote, invoice, and track job profitability by project. The contacts menu helps you manage your customers, suppliers, and other key contacts. You can check out the full list. It shows you what you owe, what you are owed, and then there are tabs for customers and suppliers if you want to look at these both separately. And you can always add new contacts by clicking on this green button up here. I hope you found that little summary useful. If there's any other accounting software that you'd like me to cover, let me know in the comments, and I'll see you in the next one.